ಕಳೆದ 40 ವರ್ಷಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬಯೋಥೆರಪಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಮುಖ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹೊಮ್ಮತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಕೆಮ್ವೆಲ್ ಬಯೋಫಾರ್ಮಾ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷ ಸಿಇಒ ಅನುರಾಗ್ ಬಗಾರಿಯಾ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಮಾಹೆಯ ಮಣಿಪಾಲ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬಯೋಥೆರಪಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಉದ್ಘಾಟಿಸಿ ಅವರು ಮಾತನಾಡಿದರು. ಅಭಿವೃದ್ಧಿ ಹೊಂದಿದ ದೇಶಗಳ ವಿಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾನಿಲಯಗಳು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಬಯೋಥೆರಪಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಸಂಶೋಧನೆಗೆ ಮಾಹೆ ಕಾಲಿಟ್ಟಿರುವಂತದ್ದು ಸಂತೋಷ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಮುಂಚೂಣಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ಕೇಂದ್ರವಾಗಿ ಈ ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಮೂಡಿ ಬರಲಿದೆ ಎಂಬ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ ಆಫ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮಾಹೆ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರಾದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರಂಜನ್ ಆರ್ ಪೈ ಮಾತನಾಡಿ, ಫಾರ್ಮಾ ಒಂದು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಬಯೋಥೆರಪಿಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ವೇಗವಾಗಿ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೆಲ್ ಥೆರಪಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆಳವಾದಂತಹ ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಸಾಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಮಾಹೆ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ನ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟಿ ವಸಂತಿ ಆರ್ ಪೈ ವೆಬ್ ಪೇಜನ್ನು ಅನಾವರಣಗೊಳಿಸಿದರು. ಈ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಹೆ ಸಹ ಕುಲಾಧಿಪತಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಚ್ ಎಸ್ ಬಳ್ಳಾಲ್, ಕುಲಪತಿ ಲೆಫ್ಟಿನೆಂಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಎಂ ಡಿ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್, ಮಾಹೆ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ನಿರ್ದೇಶಕ ಎಂ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಸಮನ್ವಯಕಾರ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕವಿರಾಜ್ ಮತ್ತಿತರು ಉಪಸ್ಥಿತರಿದ್ದರು.
One is to enhance R&D and innovation capabilities, and then to build scientific and technical experience, and to develop skillful students, researchers, and faculty. The second pillar of this is revenue generation by applying grants to industry, government agencies, foundations, and also taking CSR grants. And we have potential industry partners. With some of them, we have already signed general agreements, and discussions are in progress. ESCO Aster Singapore, Stempeutics India, Curio Biotech Switzerland, Kembel Biopharma India, Cipla Limited India, and our own Suma Genomics, the faculty entrepreneurship. And we also want to build the Center of Excellence, develop leadership and advisory and consultancy support in this segment, and develop corporate partnerships to enhance Mahe as a preferred destination for industry to come and partner to develop biological therapeutics.
We'll be inaugurating this new center, and I thank the Manipal team for this invitation. On this auspicious day of Vijayadashmi, I'm delighted to inaugurate the Manipal Center for Biotherapeutics Research. I'm very happy to see that Mahe has taken the lead in the country to establish a dedicated center for biotherapeutics research, a science that continues to gain momentum in the universities of many developed countries. I'm confident this center will emerge as one of the eminent institutions in this part of the globe. In the last 40 years, biotherapeutics has become an integral part of modern medicine to improve human health, with a focus on areas of cell therapy, gene therapy, protein therapeutics, and biomaterials. From insulin, the first modern medicine produced using biotechnological methods, to today's COVID vaccine, biotherapeutics research has come a long way.
Auspicious day of Dasara, Manipal Center for Biotherapeutics Research has been inaugurated by Mr. Anurag Bagaria, Chairman and CEO of Kembel Biopharma. As this research center is going to work closely with pharma and biopharma companies, inauguration by Anurag is very apt and meaningful. I'm glad to note, with the Institution of Eminence tag, Mahe has been expanding teaching and research activities on many fronts. The new entrant, Manipal Center for Biotherapeutics Research, aims to offer master's, PhD and postdoctoral programs in biotherapeutics, and to foster partnership with pharma and biopharma companies on new product development. Globally, biotherapeutics is the fastest growing sector in the pharma industry today. According to the Association of Biotechnology-Led Enterprises, India's biologics market will grow at a compounded annual growth rate of 22% CAGR to hit $12 billion by the year 2020.
Innovation Center in MIT. All these things are done basically to promote research and developmental activities, and also for creating many of these newer things, so that we will become the hub of entrepreneurs. We want more job creators than job seekers. That is very important for our country, because unemployment is a major problem that is facing our country. To eradicate or to reduce that, it's very important that we should have more of job creators than job seekers. All these things are done basically to promote that, and also creation of newer things, you know, patenting and other things. Recently, the other great advantage that MAHE has, we have 25 institutions or disciplines, both on the health science and technology side, as a result of which multidisciplinary research, which is very, very important, or the research of the day, that can be done easily because of the cooperation between the health sciences side and the technology side, which we are doing to the full extent. My congratulations to all the heads of the institutions who are taking a lot of active part. No, because today, even regulatory bodies insist on research and developmental activities. And I am very sure and that we got this IOE, Institution of Eminence Status, last year because of the quality of the research and developmental activities that we are doing in addition to the teaching or academic activities. So you know what, there are more than 1,500 universities in this country. When the government of the India, Ministry of Education, decided to have 6 institutions of eminence, basically to promote research activity so that we will be shown as the shining stars of the country, so that we can rather compete with the rest of the world. 3 from the private sector and 3 from the public sector are selected. Of the 3 private sectors, we are the ones. I am very happy to say that MAHE, BITS Pilani, and of course Ambani's, which is a green field, not yet started. Later, they have expanded it to 20. All these they have identified because we are a quality university, basically promoting research and developmental activity.